Once again, as we kick off the 10 o'clock hour here on Sunday at the Country, it is time we welcome in Willie Hallihan, Sporting a Cause, the website sportingacause.com, where Willie features all these different fundraisers that have an association with sports one way or another. And we welcome in Willie on this very hot and humid weekend. Hey, Willie.
Good morning, Marshall. Hope you have the AC up on high.
It is.
You know it's hot when you take a sip of coffee and beads of sweat break out on your forehead.
That's right.
As if we needed any kind of clues. There's so much going on in the coming week. Oftentimes I reference events that have already happened this weekend, but I'm not going to do that just because there's so much to talk about. I will mention a couple things going on today. The Markoe 9th Annual Racing to Save Lives, it's both a 5 and 10K, is going on pretty much as we speak over in Unionvale. That's a fundraiser for the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute. Also, our friends over at Undermountain Golf Course are hosting the Roeliff Jensen Memorial Library Golf Tournament. This is a two-flight event. There are basically two groups of people playing 18 holes, one in the morning, pretty much now, but there's another one starting at 1 o'clock this afternoon, and of course that benefits the library. And also today, from 1 to 6, this is very doable if you're of a mind, this is the first annual Canaan Railroad Days Cornhole Tournament. As you know, the Canaan Railroad Days is in full swing. It started last Thursday. It's a 10-day long thing with many, many, many events going on. And this is the first time they've had a cornhole tournament. This is organized by Mike Hogan. It's sponsored by a Great Falls Brewery. It's being held over there at Union State, the railroad station in Canaan. And it's a double elimination tournament, $25 per team. It's possible it's already filled up. I fully expected this to be very popular. Cornhole is just one of those things. It's easy to play. Anybody can do it. But also, because it's so easy, all you're doing is flicking your wrist with a beanbag. You're still outside in the heat, so make sure you hydrate. That's from 1 to 6 today over in Canaan, and it benefits the Falls Village Daycare Center. Then we move on to Thursday, the 25th, and that's the 36th Annual Great Barrington Rotary Club Golf Tournament. This is held at the beautiful Wyantna Country Club up in Great Barrington. This is one of those tournaments. It's the Rotary Club's biggest fundraiser, and they do remarkably well. They raise like $45,000 in this tournament, which is remarkable for a couple of reasons. It's the costs of a golf tournament are high, and you can only enter so many people. It's an 18-hole course. You can only have so many foursomes, and so there's a barrier to, you just can't, it's just not limitless in terms of the people who get into it. Anyway, I think most of the success is because of business sponsors. They have so many. And it goes to scholarships, which is always a very popular cause. Also Thursday, and this is I want to spend a couple minutes on this. It's Family Fun Night. Again, it's part of the Canaan Railroad Days. This is Thursday, again the 25th, over at Lawrence Field in Canaan, across from the McDonald's. And this is a fun night. There are all kinds of tents set up on the same field where the carnival just is closed up. And it's very kid-centric. There are a lot of games that kids can play. There's food and so forth. But I want to focus on one particular tent, and this is sponsored by Fairview Hospital. And they'll have two EMTs there, like they did last year, to teach people bystander CPR. Now, this is, you can learn CPR in 5 minutes. It's a shortened version, shortened from the three-hour course that people can take if they want to become an EMT or something. And I encourage people to take advantage of this. I did it last year there. I think I may have been the only person who did it, and it's too bad because everybody should know this. In 5 minutes, you can learn how to save a life. They no longer do the mouth-to-mouth part of it. If people have found that off-putting, they don't use that anymore. It's just chest compressions. It's very easy to use. They also show you how to adapt it for an infant, and it's very doable. We should all do it. And my website, Sporting a Cause, is going to donate $5 per person, up to 100 people, who take the time to learn that course that night. It's from 5 to 7, and the donation will go to the K-9 ambulance crew. So take advantage of it. In the time it takes you to order, pay for, and eat a hot dog, you can learn CPR, which is life-saving. So that's Thursday. The next day, Friday, the 26th, is the Sandy Beach Triathlon over at Bantam Lake. It's a sprint triathlon with a half-mile swim, 10-mile bike, basically a 5K run, and that benefits the Sandy Beach Restoration Project. And then the following day, on Saturday the 27th, that's going to be a busy day, the Jug End Loop Ultra Marathon. I hope it cools off by then, because this is being held over at Jug End State Reservation. Those of us who are old enough remember the Jug End, place we always used to go, same area over in Egremont. This features a 4.2-mile run, but also a 27-mile run and a 6-hour run. And this is just unbelievable that people have the ability to do these long-distance races. And that benefits the Lewison House, which is a homeless shelter in North Adams. And almost opposite of that, on the 27th, the same day, is the Insane Inflatable 5K. This is over at Dutchess County Fairgrounds. It's a 5K, but really, it's an obstacle course where these people set up 11 huge inflatable obstacles, and it's just a fun event. You know, it's not timed or anything. It's not meant to be a race so much as you just try to navigate these. They're like bouncy houses, but all kinds of different configurations. And that benefits various local charities. The same day, the 27th, is the Jane Lloyd Fund Clam Bake. Now, that's not a sports-related fundraiser, but it has a fundraiser element in it. The morning of the Clam Bake, starting at 8 o'clock, there's a non-competitive bike ride offering two different distances, a 65- or 102-mile ride. And like a walkathon, this is where the participants fundraise ahead of time and then bring their funds to the event. This is the Clam Bake is the Jane Lloyd Fund's largest fundraiser, and this bike ride contributes mightily to that. It's always very successful. The following day, on Sunday the 28th, is the Harlem Valley Rail Ride. Speaking of bicycle rides, this is also a non-competitive ride. It kind of centers over at Eddie Collins Field in Millerton, and it uses the trail, the rail trail and secondary roads. Sometimes they're on 22 for a distance. There's a lot of people riding bikes next Sunday in the Millerton area, so if you're navigating the roads, just be careful of all that. Just know ahead of time. Maybe stay off the roads if you don't want to interact with them. And they offer 8 different distances, from 23 miles up to a couple different 100-mile races. And they, too, benefit a bunch of local charities. And also, on the 28th, that same day, wrapping up the Canaan Railroad Days is the Canaan Railroad Days Run. It's a 5-mile race. It starts and ends at the Lawrence Pavilion, the same place that the Family Fun Night is held a few days earlier. And it starts at 9, and it, like 3 other races in the area, benefits the Northwest Connecticut YMCA. And Center Subaru is the presenting business for the whole 4-race series. They're very much involved in that. And then the last event on next Sunday is the Junkyard Dogs 22nd Annual Hilltopper Half Marathon. And this is presented by the Eastern Dutchess Roadrunners Club. It's free, but donations are requested for the Lustgarten Foundation for pancreatic cancer research, and that begins and ends at Millbrook School over in Millerton. And that, Marshall, wraps it up. Lots going on next week.
And hopefully next week will be cooler than it is this weekend.
Let us pray.
Let's pray. Willie, thanks for checking in. We'll speak to you again next week.
Okay, Marshall, thank you. Take care.
Willie Hallihan, Sporting Your Cause. That's sportingyourcause.com on the web.